YahooNews.com, March 7th, 2013, just a few months ago, they had an article, and this article came from, it was NewScience.com, but it was entitled, Father of All Humankind is 340,000 Years Old, okay? You can Google this, pull this up, I don't have this actual article with me, it's in another file folder, but you can check this out. They talked about a man named Albert Perry, okay, who died recently, lived in South Carolina, all right? He said DNA evidence has revealed that the oldest known common male ancestor is 340,000 years old, more than twice as old as previous estimates. New Scientist, which is, you can check this out, New Scientist online, March 13, 2013, in an article entitled The Father of All Men is 340,000 Years Old, reports that a DNA sample from a deceased South Carolina African-American man named Albert Perry shows that his Y chromosome dates back 338,000 years, even though the oldest known fossils of modern man, Homo sapiens sapiens, date back 195,000 years ago. This is shocking because all previous DNA samples date back between 60,000 and 140,000 years ago. And this is causing geneticists to have to rethink everything.
Black History Month, you find ridiculous.
What?
You're going to relegate my history to a month?
Oh, come on.
What do you do with yours? Which month is White History Month?
Jewish American History Month is in May. It was founded in 2006. Mike Wallace said he didn't want a Jewish American History Month, but he got one. So I think that interview, when I researched that interview took place, if I remember correctly, in June of 2006. So it took place right after this, but we give him a pass. Maybe he didn't get the memo. Maybe he got stuck in junk mail or email, something like that. But May 2006, recognized by Congress. National Hispanic History Month, September 15th to October 15th. Hispanics actually have two national monthly celebrations. Irish American History Month is in July. Haitian Heritage Month, May. Native American History Month, November. They got two also. Hispanic Heritage Month, September 15th, October 15th. So you have National Hispanic History Month and Hispanic Heritage Month. German American and Polish American Heritage Month are in October. These are not all of them. This is just a few. You go to BronnieLox.com and also Answers.com. You can look up cultural celebrations that break this down on BronnieLox.com. They also have the links. They also have the links to the national websites of the organizations that started these celebrations. When you study these, you'll find that all these start after 1976. 1976 is when Negro History Week becomes Black History Month and becomes a national celebration, celebrated monthly, recognized by the president. President Gerald Ford did a national address, officially recognizing something that we'd already been practicing for 50 years prior to that. All right, so we have to understand this. They saw what we had, said we wanted it too. We run away from it because we don't understand history. All right, American Bible Society presents the life of Christ. Okay, now I gotta tell you this story. I was at CBS. This is it right here. I'm not making this up. Okay, I got this November 2011. I'm standing at CBS, and you know, I pay attention to my surroundings. I'm looking at the newsstand when you check out. And I see this, I said, oh my God, what are they trying to say now? So I go through and I look at this and I turn to page 55. This book cost $12. I bought it because it was on page 55. And I said, people are not gonna believe this. Just like Richard Pryor said, I gotta get this book out of here. I had to get this book out of there. I paid for it too, just so everybody understands, all right? But what it said, page 55, said, why December 25th? It said, we don't know the actual date of Jesus' birth, but it most likely wasn't on December 25th. In Christianity's early years, people debated when Jesus' birthday should be celebrated. Some Christians were against observing it at all, as they didn't want Jesus compared to Pharaoh or Herod, whose birthdays were commemorated. Because back at that time, it was looked at as being vain for you to celebrate your birthday. But in the 4th century AD, Pope Julius I made it official. Christ's birth would be celebrated on December 25th. We're talking 336 AD. December 25th was also already considered the birthday of the Son, not the S-O-N, but the S-U-N, the Son of God. Mm-hmm. Using the technology available at the time, ancient astronomers observed that on December 25th, the days started getting longer again. They recognized the date as the winter solstice. But I break down right here, solstice coming from solstitum, sol meaning sun, stit meaning past participle of sestere meaning stand still. So winter solstice literally means the sun stands still. December 21st, it enters that constellation from the 22nd, 23rd, 24th. It said that the Son of God, the S-U-N, was hung on the cross for 3 days. The cross was the constellation known as the Southern Crux. Mm-hmm. Crux is Latin for cross.
And I walked up to the brother, and I said, Jeremiah, what you said today, brother, that was some heavy stuff. I said, I'm going to take out my pen and my paper, and I just need to write this down. I said, I'll always give you credit for saying that I heard you say it, but I'm going to say this everywhere I go. And I think this is one of the kindest ways to speak to our staunchest Christian brothers and sisters, to help them understand. It is the best way to speak to our staunchest Muslim brothers and sisters, Jewish brothers and sisters, every religion you have, as black people. Jeremiah Kamara said that day, to continue to practice and believe in a faith system that no longer meets your needs and solves your problems is like carrying the boat on your back after you cross the river. What you needed the most to get you across the river, bless that boat. But once you've crossed the river and you're walking on land, the very boat that crossed the river becomes a burden on your back when you're on the land. And it stops you. And what I'm also telling you, some of you in here are indigo adults. You need to search for your genius. Because each and every one of you is a genius. You have been given by the Creator a very special gift, unlike anybody else. But because we're always trying to compete with the other person, we're always searching and looking at that person to do better than that person, as opposed to looking within to do better today than you did yesterday, and look to do better tomorrow than you did today.